What is up, guys? Shogun here, and welcome back to another video on Treasure Wars. So today, guys, I actually want to go ahead and I want to hit up this real clue scroll that we have, because I actually want to go for some MC mode. Because if I do axes real quick, I actually have been maxed out my axes, because I've been throwing all of it into unarmed, and I think I put some of it into archery. I actually have no clue what I put into. No, it wasn't archery, but let me do MC power, actually. MC stats it is. And I'm pretty sure I put into something that wasn't that. I think I put in swords. I put 100 inch swords when I could have put that into axes. But even with 100 axes, I don't think it would have maxed out. Yeah, I'd been just below max. So I was like, why not today? We could just go ahead, try to grab some MC mode from scrolls. And then from there, we can try and go ahead. And okay, it's 25. Never mind. I thought it was 15. So yeah, so from there, we can actually go ahead and try to apply that to our axes. So hopefully it works out, and even if we don't get anything for that, we actually can go ahead and enchant 25 items. That's cool. So yeah, we can actually go ahead and let me go shop first. We could go ahead and try to grab any cool rewards that we could possibly get from that. Here we are then at shop. So let me actually just go ahead, spam buy some wood, and I should probably throw these guys out because they really aren't nothing here. So let's put all of this back in here and workbench. And my blocks look kind of dark for some reason. I think it's because of one of the mods I have on, maybe just some of them conflicting with each other, even though they shouldn't really be affecting the blocks, to be honest. But I'm not too sure because they all happened when I installed the mod. So I don't know. I'll see what's going on with that later on. So I can just go ahead and do that. And okay, yeah, I think I'm gonna have to actually head back to the base when I do this, because to be honest, I think we do have an enchantment table down, and I do need some XP on me too. So do I have a, yeah, I got this one earlier too. And either way, let's actually go ahead and workbench real quick. So we can go workbench, and then maybe I should clear some room out actually. So let me do all of this, all of these guys in here, and then from here I can go workbench, put this guy down like this, do that, and I probably didn't even need to buy that many, so I think that should be fine for now, to be honest. So I think there is a faster way to do this, but I don't really remember it, because somebody was telling me about it last week, I think. But yeah, I really don't remember what the strat was. So either way, let me actually, I probably shouldn't be taking that out, because this is even a 1.8 enchantment table. So put this thing back and just please work, dude. Actually a thing going on in Warzone right now, but I'm gonna stick to doing this. So there is actually really not a super fast way to do this, because I just asked around in chat, because I'm pretty sure somebody would have known from the amount of people in line right now, even though it is really late at night. So if I sound kind of tired, it probably is because I am tired. So either way, let's just go ahead, carrying enchanting these guys up. So put this guy back, and shouldn't have done level 2, but that's my bad. So I'm not sure how many we've had in our inventory, because I'm throwing some of them out, so I can't really count them now. So either way, by the time we finish enchanting these lots, I think we only need to do a few more. So either way, let's just carry on with these guys. And I think wooden shovels are the fastest way to do this, because I think last time I did golden swords. Yeah, I'm not too sure. I actually spent a bit of cash on that too. It really isn't that much, to be honest. But yeah, I actually spent money on it that time. Either way, this time I'm not really spending anything at all, to be honest. So let's see, we need to do 2 more items. So let's actually go ahead, grab this, and we have 7 more levels left too, so that is good. So let me go workbench real quick. We can put it down like this, this, and yeah, there you go. So it has finally spawned, so I'll just go ahead and do that. The rest of that can fall down, and I'll lightning it in a second. So this guy in here and this guy in here doesn't really matter. So there you go, mine 30 coal ore. So I guess with this one, it's just simple, plain and easy. So I could just go ahead, go spawn, and then from there, I'll go ahead and go build. And here we are then. So I actually did go back and quickly pick up my pots, my IG pet and whatnot, and I guess my extra fixer, just in case, because I always want to have these guys on me. So right now, I am in. Let me just near real quick, because it does look... Okay, I thought that was a base from the other side, but okay. Looks like somebody just gen something in there, and they really didn't gen it right anyway. And somebody really wanted to put a base there, that doesn't really look like much space. But either way, let's just carry on through here. So I found some over here, and like I said, I really should have done what I said the other day. I keep saying this every time I mine coal ore, so I actually keep saying that I'm supposed to mine these, place them down, and just wait for the restart, so that every time I can just go back, use silk and mine them up again, replace for every restart. Because if you guys don't know already, that if you mine these with silk, you can actually place them back down, and every time the server restarts, I guess it counts as fresh blocks, so you can actually do it again for free. So yeah, right now we have 18 out of 30. So I don't know why I ran out of this area, because there may be a little bit more. Yeah, there you go. So never mind. So that was really misleading, to be honest. So either way, let me actually go ahead and try find some. I could try TNT this way over here, because it does look like something could possibly be down here. Look, somebody probably x-rayed all the way here, and if a freaking thing TP's to me, an admin aware, yeah, somebody definitely x-rayed through here. So if an admin TPs to me right now and just watches this, I guess the only admin there is, Logan, or if one of the devs TPs to me, because they did get a few new devs, but I don't think they'd even be looking at me right now. I'm really not finding too much, and it is pretty dark in here, and I really can't even see it myself, so I should probably actually go ahead. And wait, let me just check my settings. Use VBOs is on, so there you go, and it's completely bright, so I don't know where I'm supposed to go to find this. Could I go down here, maybe? Yeah, it does look like we found a cave, so I really can't speak today because it's so late at night and I'm so drained of energy. So what should I actually do? Should I go ahead and grab myself a... Do I have any glowstone in the PVs? That's the real question. Can I raid shop and then try... Yeah, I was going to say, should I just be the one guy and just buy some redstone and put it down and try and make it light up with some redstone torch? But no, that's just so much wasted effort. So I can try to take that out. And then, yeah, I've got... See, guys, this is literally Minecraft survival at its finest. This is how you... Yeah, look, I only had one stick as well. This is literally how you play the game, boys. So I'm going to go ahead and make myself a torch like a general Minecraft player. Not even playing factions right now. So I can go ahead and do this. Dude, I finally found this. So let me actually go ahead and mine these guys up. So there's only two there, but maybe I should go around this area. Yeah, it doesn't look like there's anything else over here. So I should just kind of go deeper in and... put this guy down. Whoops. So yeah, I really should. Okay, it looks like somebody's actually been here too, but I doubt they'd be mining up all the coal around here, as you guys can see. So we'll just quickly go ahead and mine these guys up and we'll be done in a second. So there's actually a lot down here, so I can just do that and there you go. So now we've got extreme mine, a mine 3000 blocks. So for this one I can just slash him lava, and from this sim I'll show you guys where this is, if it is in the right spot at least, because I think I may have set him my lava somewhere else, even though yeah I did. So yeah, map actually. This is actually the arena we fought the guys in. So let me just delve home lava and let's go slash warp. Nether, was it? Yeah, nether. I'm actually so drained of energy. I don't even know the name of this warp. So we'll go nether from here. And then from nether, I guess we can go ahead and just try and find some netherrack and then just keep drilling our way from there. So I might actually time lapse that little bit there because, yeah, hopefully nobody saw me there. So if they see me, they're gonna actually fly out and chase me and probably near me down. So I'm probably gonna have to travel a little bit. So yeah, it doesn't look like anybody's behind me right now. So I'm actually gonna go ahead and not this area over here, because I think I mined around this area once before. Right, then here we go. I think I found a suitable area to do this at. So there's actually a lot of lava there. I probably should have used up my we've got 66 out of 3000. I should have used up my Giga Drill, whatever it's called. So let me quickly near as well. Maybe I should quickly... Now, I was going to say maybe I should just clean that one spot there and then start mining out. But I think it's fine the way I'm doing it now because, yeah, there's actually a lot of lava here. And I'm not even sure if there's going to be, like, enough room to me for me to just carry on drilling carelessly like this. Maybe I'm actually going to have to watch where I'm drilling. So, yeah, I'm not too sure right now. And if I mine too high up, yeah, as you guys just saw there, yeah, that's going to happen. So, I'm not too sure how I'm going to go about this. I really don't get combat tagged. So... yeah, oh no, I was about to just... Okay, whoops, I thought I had my flying, so I just mined a bit more from this area over here. There you go, so I just came down a little bit. I really didn't travel too far from the little area you guys just saw. So from here, I guess I can just go ahead and start drilling away down here. And yeah, it does look like there's a lot of space over here for me to start drilling, so that is fine for now. So I just carry on going ahead and I guess just destroying this area up. So yeah, I guess it's fine like this. So the faster I can do this, I guess the better it will be, because I don't really want anybody to find me right now. And I'll probably time lapse the rest of this. So let's just check how much we have. 808. So once it gets to 1000, I guess it'll be a third. Thank you. there we go. Now I've got a sizzle, a crunch, and a crack. So that's probably the worst thing I could have gone right now, because I think we could have actually grinded through a lot more easy ones, such as plant 25 saplings or whatnot. And right now it is actually morning, so we're actually, I don't know how long it's going to take us to do this step over here. So yeah, I'll probably leave this one for a little bit, and then I guess we should carry on once it is done. I'm not sure if I should time-lapse this bit either, because I just time-lapsed the whole bit with the mining section, so I think it'd be best if I just cut this part out. So yeah, it's actually going to go all the way down, and then once it goes, it's going to go all the way back around like that. Alright guys, now we are at shops. I'm actually going to go ahead and grab out this and this, and as you guys probably saw already, I don't know if I showed it in the video, but I actually have the craft, the compass thing, so let me quickly go workbench, and then from here I can do this. And iron block, and it looks so weird because I don't know, for some reason, like I said already, my textures are deformated and they're a lot darker than they're meant to be. So we've got mine one enderman spawner, which really shouldn't be that hard. There you go. So I actually have one tree. I was just about to say, do I really need to buy one of these? Because as you can see by my bow, I'm pretty much broke. I had to give all my bow to console. He doesn't even have him on it, if he doesn't have it on him either, and if he actually spent it, because we were actually saving up to a knife, I'm gonna be mad. So now we have 430 blocks and survive. So this is what I was actually talking about earlier when I meant we could have grinded through these really easy ones, and then we had to get something like mine 30. I'm not mine 30, we had to get the sizzle crunch, but either way, it doesn't really matter too much. So right, nice. So now I am at the wilderness, so I should just go PV4 and throw all of this crap in here, and I don't need that, I don't need that, and I could throw all of this in there too, so that is good. So I don't think I need that either, actually. I'll just keep this one on me for now, because I think I may need it. So I need to go kit starter, and then from there I need to, holy crap, that's kind of loud. I should actually go ahead and pick up the stone. So there you go, pick up the stone, pick up the sand. So with this I can go ahead and turn my fly off real quick. So first you need to do this, fall twice, fall again, and there you go. So now I've taken some fall damage. This only applies to god ranks, you need to do that, and then you can go ahead and just build up to 30 real quick. So I actually need to land right evenly here, so I need to have 2 blocks left over. So there you go, and then I guess I can just go ahead, fall over here, and there you go, it finished instantly. Shoot. So yeah, I think I'm gonna have to do my rewards thing. So let me just quickly throw all of this crap out. So we've got a peg, speed booster, critical shot, 4 gapples, and not really sure what else I got. So I'll check that in a sec. So enchantment rune, soul gem, skill gem. So is it rewards? I don't really remember. Clue, scroll, rewards, slash clue rewards. I really don't remember. I didn't spell that right. Okay, there it is. So clue rewards, soul gem I got. Skill gem 5 and arm, so that really isn't what I was going for, because I actually do have max and arm, as you guys know. But yeah, that sucks that you get that. All items have been cleared from your reward overflow. So there you go. If you guys didn't know that, come on now, you do. So the more you know. I don't know how much I'm actually going to do this for. So item anyone want to buy, because I actually do need to make a bit more cash. So let's see if anybody tries and buys that. And then I can try AH sell this guy over here for about... there's not really too many people online, so I'll go 45k, because this isn't really too good of a time to be sending these. So 100k first bid. So anybody over 100k, so let me actually do this selling. Current bid equals 100k by what's his name, Cleaving. So all right, there you go. Is anybody gonna say anything else? We've got 100k, and I think I may just have to sell it to him. V1 Cleave it. Oh yeah, never mind. Okay, I thought there was alright, there you go. So 150k by this guy. Let me see his name. Jamison. So this is actually how you sell your stuff for a lot more than I guess what you'd sell them for on the AH. So Jamison. And he goes 175k again. So okay, that's going up really fast. So Cleaving, there you go. And from there, I guess we've got a pet XP booster as well, so I may apply this later on when I'm spamming my thing down. So then we've got 200k by this Jamis guy. So let's go Jamis, and there you go, our soul gem has also been bought, so that is good. So we can go 200 over here, and is this guy gonna, we got outbid, so let me see what he says. Is this guy gonna go any higher? If not, then I guess we can just go ahead and sell this to him. I've also got a cow spawn, which I could probably hitch up for a little bit too, so I'd say like, actually no, I'm gonna keep the cow spawn on me, to be honest. I don't really want to sell that just yet. So now we're up to 205k by Cleaving again. So 205k, and it's actually really near late at night, so not many people are on, so I may have actually sold this for a little bit more than what I'm sending it for now. So let me actually do this instead of writing the whole message again. So yeah, is anybody gonna do it? And if I accidentally right click it, it's just gonna be completely derpy, because I'm gonna end up applying it to myself. It's just gonna be so ripped. So we've got 210k by, I guess he said it first, so we're gonna have to say it to him. to 210k by Jamison Claw. So here we go again. I think I'll just take a cut over here until we actually get this guy sold. So I'll see you guys back in a second. And there you go. So it just finally sold for 400k by my boy Christian over there. So it actually ended up going up to 500k. But then I guess the guy who bid 500k bidded it after I said sold. So I couldn't actually sell it to him, which kind of sucks because I guess that would have been an easy extra 100k, but it doesn't really matter that much anyway. So right now we're up to 450k after having like basically 1k or something. I'm not even sure. We had basically no money. We've got a few other things we can sell slash use. I think I'm going to use this guy over here in the next episode, and I guess we'll just start spamming him every once in a while. We'll start spamming our IG packs. I do that every episode anyway, to be completely honest. So yeah, we'll probably do that soon. So I think I may actually have to wrap it up here, guys. So if you guys did enjoy today's episode of Factions, be sure to leave a like, subscribe to me, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace out, everyone.